And there's really no way to explain it. It just...
The girl has happened. Lay? It's the same girl that was in the bleepy bloop picture on Hipster Runoff. I think.
Her name's Leah.
Leah. She's pretty chill, it seems like. Anywho, we were hanging out in Tao's, hotel. It was pretty chill as heck.
He had a nice hotel room.
We were taking funny pictures.
Yeah, there's a lot of funny pictures. They had well, it's not really a bushel, was it? They had a thing of apples in the wait room.
Cheese step! Nathan Cheese step. Nice, Garrett. Boost! I'll read my story.
Yeah.
Where is it? It's on my computer.
I like your story a lot. I think it's funny.
Me too. I want to write more.
I wrote something the other day that was like really probably terrible called Amnesiac.
Oops.
Amnesiac Steven, who also has no legs. I don't know what that was about.
Okay, this is a short story that I wrote in the body of an email to a girl named Heather on Twitter. Because she tweeted something about reading A Rose for Emily and wishing that there was, saying that there should be a story called A Rose for Heather, and so I said that I'll write one, and I did. This is it. A Rose for Heather. Heather is cool as heck. She lives in an old-ass home that no one knows if she is even alive in the house. Her favorite games are playing foosball and watching hockey on TiVo. Well, Heather is one of the best humans alive, and she eats a lot of interesting foods, such as chocolate cake. Yeah, that's Heather for you. Aw, I think she's cool.
Cool.
Anyway, one day Heather gets a package in the mail. It says on big letters, "Hi, Heather." Lol. It's a bomb, though. Heather knows it is a bomb because she is a smart girl. She says audibly in her own home, "God damn, that's a bomb." Well, that sucks. The bomb explodes and Heather dies. But she's happy as hell. Guess why? She got into heaven. The end. Oh! Pow! Pow! What does Steven think of me leaving him? God damn. Goddamn boost. Come with me, Steven. Come with me and come on me.
Yes. Hey, Dave Shaw.
Dave Shaw! Goddamn, I love how, like, everyone who I love is in here almost.
What does it take to get in frame? Dave Shaw, I often think about making a literary mixtape. Often.
Gotta plug in the thing.
There. Should we? For a little temporary move?
Really, Phil?
What's you feeling? Popcorn?
Yeah, I think so. I just ate a bunch of white rice, so I don't really need it, but I'll make it for you.
You don't have to make it.
Well, we could make it a bit later, too.
Yeah, that would work.
Steve, can you show me how you cooking dance? I don't really cooking dance. I do my own dances, although they are inspired by Lil B's energy. Lil B, with the cooking dance, a lot of it is this shuffling of the shoulders and, you know, you're cooking out here, you know? And when I do the using computer dance, it's a very similar vibe. I often get the shoulders going in the same way, and I'm just typing, and I try to keep my own brand on tap. Can I dance and have food appear? I wish. Actually, I'm not hungry right now, so no, I don't wish. But you gotta get wrapped up in these, too. Oh, this is a good idea. This looks sexy. Sexy as fuck getting wrapped up in this shit. This is a good-ass thing. Good-ass idea.
Yeah, okay.
Make me dream. Rachel Bell is calling me. I don't
pick
know.
Up.
I don't know if she's even one of the people watching it. Hi, Rachel.
You're in Chicago. Report to our apartment.
Hi. Are you watching the thing or no? Oh, okay. That's funny then. Okay.
She's in Chicago. She should come to our apartment.
You're not in Chicago anymore, though. Oh, really? Boost. Well, I hope it goes well for you.
He's just on the phone. No big deal, guys. He's just ignoring you.
Where do you live? Well, I hope
what?
It goes well for you. No, it's warm. You'll feel freaking warm as heck.
Is there like a delay? I think there is.
What kind of north? What part of North Carolina? Jesus. Cool.
I really feel good being wrapped in lights, guys. Uh-huh. It's really boosted me a lot.
Oh.
Krimbus.
Sweet.
Krimbus.
I don't know that much about Mookfest. Boost. Okay. Talk to you soon.
Guys.
Bye.
That was Rachel Bell.
By the way, she's thinking about moving to Asheville, North Carolina.
Is she not in Chicago anymore?
No, she moved home. She's in Indianapolis. God. It's kind of hot with these lights. These lights are heating me right up, guys!
Pop Serial 3 is coming out early next year. I'm just waiting on some people to turn in their shit. Wait, hold on. Let me, in case any of these people don't know...
popserial.tumblr.com. Yeah! If y'all got Tumblr, Pop Serial is the place to be.
If you're not...
You'll be way more locked into the community happenings if you follow the Tumblr.
It's only the number one journal in existence.
Yeah, really, you know. That's my site, Ask Jeeves. Wow, I like Tumblr. Pop cereal swings good.
Don't mind me. Just promoting.
Promoting my life. So
it's a nerd to type in like you porn.
Y'all got Tumblr?
Tumblr. Would that be just tasteless if I like link to like a specific porn? Probably.
If anybody wants to type in their Tumblrs and just follow each other, it's okay with me, but no guarantee that we'll do it, that people will do it. Check this out, what I got when I went to see Tao Lin. Look at me, guys. Who wants this in their package? Who ordered books from me? Anybody who knows who can get it? It's going to be in a random package.
Oh, it's so warm.
I know, it heats you right up.
Jackson, we're going to meet you in like fucking couple months there, buddy.
Jackson, Effing Newland. Jacob, if you want books from me, then order them. They're running out. They're not running out, there's a lot, but... I'll type in the link to my fundraiser if you guys don't know it. It's livemylife.com/fundraiser, though. It's a pretty simple link. It's been endorsed by Tao Lin and John Campbell. When we were hanging out in Tao Lin's hotel, there was disposable headphones in the fitness room. Disposable headphones. Live my life. This is real shit.
Guys, we watched Limitless, and it made me want to sleep.
Yes. Anybody can give me money. You don't need to have my stuff mailed to you. And I'll hug you forever. Spiritually and probably physically.
He hasn't yet specified. Never mind. I was going to say something off color.
Oh my god! Hey! What am I going to say? I was going to say something. Oh, boost. Hug you with a bullet. I'll hug you with a bullet in your head! Are we having a showcase in South by Southwest? I don't know, I'm sure something... Every place I go, there will probably be some kind of event. Or at least a Ustream from that location.
Why did Stacy say you? Oh, about Jackson's peen, probably. What?
Jackson, I can smell my peen from here. I screenshotted Jackson's comment. That's hilarious.
I like Lilith's comment. I'll give you censored when I see you IRL.
Wow. Garrett, live my life. Boost. Okay. What was I thinking about before?
Does it censor cock?
Test the censored peens.
Guys, does it say censored right now or cock? Looks like censored.
Censored. Censored.
So it doesn't censor peen, though.
Well,
guys, you can say peen or you can say cock like that, yeah. Wait, hold on.
Peen lifestyle.
But it's a sock, though, and it's like punch it, I guess.
Sock my cock, yeah.
I didn't mean for it to be sexual, more like a hurting the penis.
Hurting.
It was more about hurting the penis than pleasing it.
Hurt the penis.
I feel like I'm getting choked by this warm thing.
You gotta get it off your neck skin and onto your shirt, and then it's boost be good for you.
Boosted.
Oh my god!
Oh my god!
Oh my god, let me just read a little excerpt from the Tao Te Ching.
Well, Jesus.
Somebody's getting this, I forget who. It's a little mini version of the Tao Te Ching. Read this, just get you... It's a little bit... The Taoism is nice and chill as fuck. It'll calm your ass down a little. It'll make you not want to be a pompous ass. Which I feel like sometimes I still am. No. But it's in a way that people usually like, so... Here's the thing. Maybe it'll take me a second to find it. Mm-hmm. Pompous ass life.
Whoop.
Here's one. Who would be wise in word and deed, and free from sensual strife, permits each sense to serve his need, but not to rule his life?
Oh my god.
Means you take what you can, but you don't, you know. Serve his peen, exactly, you got it right. Permits each sense to serve his peen, but not to rule his life, and of course the spelling on life... So, L-I-E-F. Trying to find the ones that I remember. Surf that peen. Surf his peen. JDA, I'll sign your life away.
Wait, can you get one of these is a...
Live rock. My leaf. Nathan, cheese step. A lot of people pronounce it leaf. It was funny... The one reading I did in Wicker Park here in Chicago, the woman who introduced me had like a whole paragraph of her introduction based on the idea that I was bringing back this old English word, leaf, L-I-E-F, and that it meant beloved, and that I was bringing back that. And I was like, well, I just think of it as a misspelling of life, but...
What I'm trying to say is that some people are dumb.
They're not dumb, it's just funny that they read different things into it. I don't know. I don't know what it... I don't know what it ultimately means, but it's funny.
No, it doesn't mean that. I was just...
The holy man will never try to rule with sword or rod.
content to set his hand, his standard high, he leaves the rest to God. Check this shit out. A prying government will do the people endless harm. He is the wisest ruler who governs in peace and calm. Holy shit.
That sounds like some Republican shit.
It is some, it's vaguely, vaguely laissez-faire. But I see it not as much as a literal statement about government, but about controlling the stuff in your life. If you got shit going on in your life, if you stress about controlling it, then you're not actually going to be in control of it. You just got to sort of waver over it and let it sort of cool up. See my life? You should change your name to Rodney. Why should I change my name to Rodney? And who are you, person who said that? Because that I still didn't know who you were. Rodney Roggenbuck. That'd be a good pen name. Good idea. I'll do that. Hmm. Does a dog have Buddha nature or not? No. Does a dog have Buddha nature or not? Yes. That's a fucking sweet thing, JDA. Jada Pinkett Winslow. Cheese Steps roommate? Boost. Lil Wayne. Damn, good point. Who's Ollie fan? Oh, that's Tutty. Okay, boost. That makes sense. I got to the end of the name and then I knew.
I want to read this eventually, but I think we should read some more like comical things before I read more like deep stuff.
Wash your frickin' bowl! What should we read? I could read still even more of this, but check this shit out! This shit will make you patient as fuck reading this. Read this shit while you're sitting next to a...
Results may vary.
Next to a snowbank. This will make you as patient as shit. Check this out. The holy man will never feel impatient to improve. Because he knows the mighty wheel must turn in its own groove. See, a lot of this stuff's about vibing in the natural flow of things, you know? Zen, the Taoism has a lot to do with the... shit about nature, you know? This is the Tao Te Ching. This is probably a bad translation. It's like a really cheap little old thing. It seems really bad. It's like, and it's made to rhyme. But it's just what I have. It's the only thing I've read about Taoism. I've heard a lot of people say that they like the Tao of Pooh. And I think they use, like, the Winnie the Pooh characters as a thing to illustrate stuff about the Tao, but I haven't read it. But I'm like, bro, seems like a thing that's, like, meant, why is it about, why does they use the Winnie the Pooh characters? Why don't they just live their life? And actually, people said that it's actually very good, so... Marcus Aurelius. I don't know who that is. I like that Jada's having complete the cone contest. Complete the cone contest in the Ustream chat. If you're not in the Ustream chat, you're missing out. Shayna Gordon, hi.
Hi, Shayna.
Kitty's using the toilet. Cat's in the toilet. What's up? Do you want to read that yet? Or
No.
Not sure yet? No, not yet?
Maybe later.
Okay.
There's gotta be something else to read.
Yeah, was there something short and funny recently?
If you having girl problems, I feel bad for you, son. I got 99 problems, but if you ain't one, hit me. 99 problems, but if you ain't one. If you having girl problems, I feel bad for you, son. I got 99 problems, but if you ain't one, hit me. Ninety
rated M for mature.
Tumblr, and he seems like he actually gets...
I assume Roggenbuck approved.
He seems like a lot of people seem to get into...
Is he in the scene, or is he out of the scene?
He's not deeply entrenched in the scene, but he knows a couple
Has
people.
Has he been published places?
I don't think many official places, no. There's this image macro thing that has a picture of a cat, and it's got these rainbow colors, and it says over it, in all caps, italics, "We kissed, and everything was dark but the moon, and we were stars, and the ocean was there, too." That was pretty chill, I thought. And a lot of the text, there's plain text poems, and there's image-based things.
Did you steal that idea from you, the stock photo?
I don't know with that specific one. I think I knew him at that point. But,
inspired by this beautiful post.
But it wasn't mine. It was a different... It was just what the quote was from. He had been doing image things before meeting me, though, I think. So, there's another image macro
thing.
He would
fit into your group pretty easily.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I was excited to find him. There's a picture that has, like, in a hospital room bed, or no, is that a checkup room or some crap?
Yeah, like for a physical?
Yeah, it says over it, "I thought about getting your name tattooed on my thigh again, but only in a funny way, and I wonder what you taste like, I wonder what I taste like."
Ooh, cool.
Sexual as fuck. That has 41 notes, too.
I
feel like he's vibing.
I don't even really think of it so much as sexual as just kind of, like, sad and, like, depressing.
Oh, I can see that. There's also this plain text poem I'm going to read that I linked from my Twitter just recently. It's titled, "WebMD Says I'm Fine, Mom. I feel earthquakes, like, 3 times a day. But every time I go onto Google and search earthquake, it says there was no earthquake near me. Am I sick?" And might read one more. I don't know what one to read. I don't remember which ones I like the most. Most of them, I had a vibe by it, like they ended in a way that made me feel like, yeah, that was good. And he had a contest. Yeah, seems like he's got some cool stuff going on. Cute, clapping, Dave Shaw, Vicky Tingle, Jada Winslow dominating the chat with the Collins.
Nice. Digging
Mark Thomas Stevenson? No, it's not him. Though he's chill as fuck. So those things I just read was from this... Mark Soak, and he's also on Twitter, and I'll even give you his Facebook, because I like when people are connected, and he seems chill as heck. Yeah, okay, bro?
Yeah.
eHarmony bio. Boost. Is that on this page? Should I read it? Another? eHarmony bio. "Calling people vapid, is honestly like my third favorite hobby. I also like listening to the sound of people yelling at me in anger and touching female breasts." eHarmony bio. Boost. Okay. Slam dunk myself. Oh, JDA Winslow sent me another thing in Facebook chat.
Facebook. I should read something by me that I don't know what.
By you?
Yeah.
Yeah, that'd be good.
Me as well.
Drummond John. Which John are you? Drummond John? Just bought some swag. Angela, what did you buy? John Hobgood. He's Hobgood. You know John Hobgood? He's a little B enthusiast. Little B.
He said read the snow poem. Oh, by him.
Read the snow poem, nothing else. Didn't I already read that? I already read it. No. I can't tell what's a different thing, JDA. John C. Lilly. About running. Okay, I'll read this by JDA Winslow. I don't know when it ends. Does it lend it, end it? The word Zen? Read Beyonce lyrics out loud. Damn, that's a good idea.
I would do that.
Steven's going to read Beyonce lyrics out loud after this.
Any requests as to which Beyonce song?
Angela, you bought books. That's awesome.
I'm gonna read Upgrade You lyrics, I've decided.
JDA, no, I did not ruin the ending. I did not ruin it, I promise you. I know the poem very well.
Michael, I'm going to be reading Upgrade You lyrics.
Hi, Alexi. Fresh. Whose Christmas tree am I on top of, BTW?
That is really hilarious.
That is...
I like that a lot.
Spoilers. This is by Jada Pinkett Winslow. You can look him up at... What's your Twitter URL? Type it in. Jada Pinkett Winslow. So I'm lying on my bed, naked. I've just run through snow as some pseudo-romantic exercise. It was a shameless promotion of my absence of self. My own exercise in separation. Less rising above, more stepping outside. I get cramp down all three of my sides. I've never felt less zen. Seems... Well, you gotta have the whole URL so people can click it. I mean, if it's not clickable, who's gonna type that in? Jada Pinkett Winslow. Load him up. Wow.
I feel like...
I really liked... It was a shameless promotion of my absence of self. Anyway.
I think these Beyonce lyrics have some inaccuracies. I'm looking for another site, guys.
It might be funny if they had an accuracy. Maybe not.
But not funny ones. The humor there to me was the fact that I know that they're inaccurate. But that's
pretty
funny to me.
I see. Put your face on Angel. Alyssa put your face on Angel on her Xmas tree, and her roommates were really weirded out.
That's sweet as hell.
That's funny. That's good.
Well, which one is Alexi? Which Alexi?
She's from the...
What's her last name?
Jeshel.
Oh, Jeff.
Is it Jeshel or Geshel or...
I'm going to read these Beyonce lyrics, I think. Can I take your seat?
Yeah.
Well, I don't have to. I guess if we just get me in frame, I don't know.
I have to have these lights around me.
You can scoot up a little. Somebody send me a site with a page that has a lot of cones on it.
All right. Alright guys, this is Beyonce, Upgrade You. I think it's from the album B-Day, maybe. This is for Michael Hesselmeyer. Okay, Upgrade You by Beyonce. Actually, there's some parts by Jay-Z at the beginning, I think. Okay. I hear you be the block, but I'm the life... Oh, this is fucked up too! Alright, these lyrics are fucked up. I hear you be the block, but I'm the light. Oh, fucking A. God damn it, guys. You don't understand how frustrating this is. I don't know. I don't know it well enough to, like, remember what the right words are. You know, Michael, do you feel me? I mean, I know it's something about I'm the lights that keep the... I'm the something that keeps the... Ah, oh, fuck.
Damn.
It's just, they got them.
Try songmeanings.net, Garrick Littler says.
God damn it. All these people have the wrong lyrics.
Do you think you have the wrong lyrics?
No.
My class of mouse says, it's okay, let me shine my light.
Alright. I hear you be the block, but I'm the light that keeps the streets on. Notice you the type of like to keep them on a leash, though. I'm known to walk alone, but I'm alone for a rezone. Sending me a drink ain't a P-zone, believe me. Come harder, this won't be easy. Don't doubt yourself, trust me, you need me. This ain't a shoulder with a chip or an ego, but what you think they all mad at me for? You need a real woman in your life. That's a good look. Taking care of home but still fly. That's a good look. I'm going to help you build up your account. That's a good look. Better yet, a hood look. Ladies, that's a good look. Believe me. When you're in those big meetings for the mills, that's a good look. You take me just to compliment the deal, that's a good look. And anything you cop, I split the bill, that's a good look. Better yet, a hood look. But ladies, that's a good look. Believe me. Partner, let me upgrade you. Audemars Pig... Well, obviously, I'm not rich because I don't know how to say that. Switch your necktie to purple labels. Upgrade you. Let me upgrade you. Partner, let me upgrade you. Partner, let me upgrade you, flip a new page, introduce you to some new things and upgrade you. Let me upgrade you. Partner, let me upgrade you. I don't think this is very exciting. I can do
it. You gotta get into it.
Well, I'm doing the right...
Pretend that you're at a poetry slam.
I'm doing the right... if anyone's heard the song, I'm kind of doing the rhythm. I know rhythmically what I'm doing.
I know you're doing the rhythm. I feel that.
But I'm not gonna, like, do an impression of Beyonce. I can do for you what Martin did for the people, ran by the man, but the women keep the tempo. It's very seldom that you're blessed to find your equal. Still play my part and let you take the lead role, believe me. I'll follow. This could be easy. I'll be the help whenever you need me. I see your hustle. With my hustle, I can keep you. Focused on your focus, I can feed you. All right, guys, I'm not enjoying this. I don't think it's funny either. The whole, like, I don't know. I'm not going to make commentary. I'm not fun, Steve. I'll be honest with you.
This is a picture of Dom kind of Sally watching the Ustream.
See, the thing is, guys, I'm not trying to be ironic here. Beyonce makes good music, okay? I'm not trying to be ironic here. Fuck irony.
It's not funny and it's not cool. Somebody, who's Puffy again? I forget. Jesus Christ. When people have different names than who they actually are. This is Dom Carnicelli.
Yeah, Peter B. You know how I feel, because I don't think white people like singing or covering black music is funny. I think it's awesome. So there's nothing funny about it.
So that's Live My Life.
Guys, I'm not a fun.
Bro, it seemed like a funny idea. Not like a funny idea, but like a idea that was good.
Yeah.
Boost my...
I'm just not into that particular type of irony.
Well, not even in an ironic...
I'm glad that people love me, even though I bombed.
Let's just celebrate music.
What should I read?
Do you guys love music? Because I do. If we didn't already read that on a thing, it would be the obvious.
We already did that, though.
I know. We already fucking... What is post-post irony? Good point. Let's bring it around.
Vicky, I'll do whatever you want.
Vicky!
Because you own
me. Vicky owns Steven, so yeah, just.
Just put me at your disposal.
If you need anything, Vicky, just request it. Steven will do it right now.
Well, not. Well, yeah. Just
well,
at
possibly,
any time.
At any time.
There's no rush.
There's no rush, but she owns you.
Yeah. That's cool. Who is Alafanatuti?
It's Ali Tuddy, I believe, from the UK.
Hey, Garrett, I've been hearing a lot about your blog there, buddy.
Garrett!
Buddy, old pal.
Got that blog life.
Which, well, I shouldn't read again, but what would you read by from this stuff? It's all old, but I don't know if people have heard it. I was kind of drawn to this, but...
What the fuck does real life...
Well, I think that's a great piece, but for obvious reasons, I don't know if I feel like reading it. Also, people have probably heard it.
I see, yeah, that was one of my favorites from the archives as well.
I definitely don't want to read... I don't want to read...
Or I liked your poems at New Wave Vomit, the 5 poems, I think.
Oh, yeah.
Those were good, too.
Well, anyways,
for similar reasons.
Jada, are you leaving? Oh my god.
Jada Pinkett Winslow is leaving the party.
I really like thinking of you as Jada Pinkett Winslow. That's great.
Bye. Oh god, okay.
Do you guys ever listen? Oh, you know what we should. Well, I don't really feel like playing music, but. You guys ever hear the Chipmunks Christmas album? That's pretty sweet.
We can just have it on in the background.
Do you know the Chipmunks guys, like with the high voices? You know about them?
Seems like people would know them.
Chipmunks are great.
Does E.E. Cummings have a Christmas poem? I feel like he would.
He might.
I mean, he has winter poems.
He covers all his bases.
He has winter poems. I'll read a winter poem by him. He has some religious poems, too, but I don't know of them. Okay. I'm going to read an E.E. Cummings
that was loud.
Winter poem. I know, but I had the explosive energy when I saw it in the book. Swag, swag, swag. Swag, 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 swag. Tree about Christmas tree. I'll see if I can find it, Hasselmile. This one is titled Snow, S-N-O. Snow, a white idea. Listen, drenches Earth's ugly mind. Rinsing with exact death the annual brain, clotted with loosely voices. Look, look, skillfully, fingered by a parenthesis, the pond, on whose swooning edge black trees think. Here little knives of flower, stroppings of a thick silence. Black trees think. Tiny angels sharpen themselves on air. Don't speak. A white idea, drenching. Earth's brain detaches, clottings, and from a annual ugliness of rinsed mind slowly, from the a winding putrescence, a of loosely voices.
I remember that one from class, from college.
From class, damn.
Yeah, I had like a modernist poetry class.
Damn. It's called Tree, Michael?
I want to see if there's any of your books that I feel like reading.
Okay, some of them are already packaged up.
Yeah.
Tree.
That's okay.
Yeah.
Are you selling your Orlovsky?
I don't have Orlovsky.
You don't have any Orlovsky?
I just have him in the anthologies.
Does he have actual books?
He has one that is very rare. It's out of print.
That's the only one, really?
Yeah.
Wow. I really want a copy of an Orlovsky book. I feel like if I ever found one or got one, I'd be really excited.
Yeah.
I feel like that'd be a dope thing to have.
Michael, I don't find it. Oh, Little Tree. That.
Did someone already buy I Heart Huckabees?
No. Nobody bought I Heart Huckabees from me yet.
I love that.
Pretty sure. Somebody can own it on DVD for a low price of optional donation. Actually, you'll need to donate something, because I at least want the shipping covered.
I love that movie.
This was in E.E. Cummings' first book, Tulips and Chimneys. Boost my life.
Is there anything funny in Pop Serial 2 right here? Oh,
there's a lot of
them, sorry. I'm not trying to self-promote, it's just I want something exciting.
Right? Yeah. Ah, this is, I'm reading from Little Tree. Little Tree, little silent Christmas tree. You are so little, you are more like a flower. God damn, that's a good opening stanza. Who found you in the green forest, and were you very sorry to come away? See, I will comfort you because you smell so sweetly. I will kiss your cool bark and hug you safe and tight. Just as your mother would, only don't be afraid. Look, the spangles, that sleep all the year in a dark box, dreaming of being taken out and allowed to shine. The balls, the chains, red and gold, the fluffy threads. Put up your little arms, and I'll give them all to you to hold. Every finger shall have its ring, and there won't be a single place dark or unhappy. Then when you're quite dressed, you'll stand in the window for everyone to see, and how they'll stare. Oh, but you'll be very proud. And my little sister and I will take hands, and looking up at our beautiful tree, we'll dance and sing, Noel, Noel. God damn! That's a pretty good poem. I especially like the opening
few stanzas there.
Think about reading Ben Brooks, although I think you've read him before on Ustream.
Willow Tree by Dean Cummings.
You've probably read this before, but not to the same
I've audience. Read parts of it. Yeah, different people.
I would read his new one for the upcoming issue, but maybe I should save that for the upcoming issue. Low gesture scrolling sticks. Alright guys, this is by Ben Brooks. It's from Top Serial number 2. Alright. It's called It's Okay, We're Okay, I'll Say We Couldn't Sleep. And then in parentheses, half remembered pictures from a long while ago. Ben Brooks.
Y'all fucks with Plath.
Mm-hmm. Would this be boring to read?
No, it's you have to just read it with some...
It's beautiful, Core, right?
Tempo.
Okay. There are wood blocks in the barn. We carry them out, lay them in the snow behind the house. I love you. We are 8 years old. Your coat makes you look like a crashed hot air balloon. We stack the blocks. We build a cabin. You sit on one side. I sit on the other. You tell me we have no roof. I say, what do you expect me to do about it? You stop talking. Soon I walk outside. I take more blocks. I make a wall between us and the house. You say we have no roof. I say, I know we have no roof. You ask me what we'll do if it snows again, if it rains. I say, you stay on your side. I'll stay on mine. It starts to snow. You start to cry. You hum to hide the sounds. The sounds get through the wall. The sounds get near to me. I undress slowly to my underwear. I take it all off. I don't fold it. I stand up and I swing my arms and the whole house comes down. You aren't crying anymore. You're staring. My mother comes out of the house. She asks me what I'm doing. I tell her, I don't know. We lie close in the hay in the barn. Our breath makes white jellyfish drift in the air over our heads. I don't know it, but I'll grow. This is Ben Brooks, guys. She's our babysitter. She's sexy. I'm only small, but I know she's sexy. I know I want to put my hands all over her skin. I want to know she's warm and okay. She's sat in the armchair. She's 14. She's smoking. Our babysitter doesn't speak English. Why would she speak in Latvian, she says to me. She's bored. I say I'm bored. She says my parents left the car keys. Should we drive? And I nod. We're in the car. We're driving. She's 14. She can't drive. She doesn't know how. She's just going up the road when it stops and won't start. We get out. We look at the car. The car does nothing. Not even a cough. Not even a shiver. And there's snow in its creases. It don't feel them, though. We rub our hands by the car, then a man comes past, and our babysitter asks him, can he start the car? Can he turn it round? The man says he can, and he can. When we go home, I go to the back room, I put a blanket over my head, I say every new word I've learned today. Behind the house over the brook, there's a field, there's a small wooden izba with two rooms, there's a boy in the izba, and his father and his mother. His father has a tumor in the shape of a pipe, he has spectacles wound over taped 1,000 times. He has whole missing fingernails, and his left eye always points upward. When the boy finishes his day field threshing, we sit out by his izba. We play cards. It's simple. Highest winds. Play for hours. What else? We're sat there, heavy sun, and he's barely wearing clothes. And I say, we're going soon. We're going away. He says, where are you going? I say, back. He asks about England. I tell him we don't drink goat's milk there. I tell him there are less bonfires and more people, and he nods like he already knew it. He asks me to write him, and I nod, but he's got no address and can't read, so I think I'll maybe send him sketches of the city buildings and of the trains and trucks. He asks, are we taking the potato patch with us? I tell him, no, I don't think we are. There's a pine forest behind, an unclear pond in front. There are wolves in the forest. There are koi in the pond. The wolves are loudest. Dad says we shouldn't be scared of the wolves. They are more scared of us, he says. I say, I don't think you understand exactly how scared of them I am. I say that sometimes I sit on the bear rug by the fireplace and I think about a wolf padding in through the kitchen, into the hall, over to me, fitting my entire head into its mouth, turning my neck into a red fireworking stump, pulling purple scarves out of my stomach. Then him and my mom and mum will come home and I'll be in pieces and he'll get the gun, shoot the wolf, over and over and over to stop it shouting, but it will shout the forest, emptying of wolves, the house filling with them, just eating everyone, moving upstairs and downstairs, wrestling with each other, leaving red smudges on all the walls. Dad laughs, zips up his fly, tells me to calm, and we walk between the trees.
Ben Brooks!
We might need an energy boost.
Bust?
Boss.
Taylor Retzios, Jesus Christ, censored Cuba Gooding Jr., clapping, damn, calp. Garrett Litter just posted a twit pic. What's it of? It's of him. Congrats, bro.
You look a little bit, got a little bit of rape gaze going on there, bruh.
You think he's rape gazing that picture?
I think you're rape gazing me, bruh.
I feel like
you're rape gazing me.
He's got a little, I'm digging his swag. I think he's got a style.
I'm not dissing him, I'm just saying he looks...
Nice color for a shirt, too. I always wanted a shirt that color, a little bit of a light green in there. A little bit of bright light green in there.
Yep.
Very nice reading.
Oh, that's good. That's good.
Get your life in order.
Garrett, if you're going to do that, you have to be holding it out like this. Like.
I saw the MySpace angle that you were going for a little, but there's more you could have done.
And
to
you need more bangs, bruh.
Oh, I'm sorry, I messed it up for you there. I'll just push it back.
Okay.
I'll just push it back right in there.
That's okay.
There you go. Wait, let me... Christmas Dierks! MySpace Christmas. It's a MySpace Christmas.
It's gonna be a MySpace Christmas.
Jesus, how many MySpace friends did you have, Alexi Jeschel? I had 300!
Hey, I never was on MySpace, guys.
Steven never had a MySpace. That's
I was never emailed, bros.
Check this out. I was talking to
Shannon.
But I am
Shannon. Emotional.
I was talking to Shannon Vislocki, and she had Friendster before MySpace. I didn't even have Friendster.
How old is this person?
Who here had Friendster?
You guys are too young
to
be on
couple,
Friendster.
She's a couple older years older than me.
You gotta be old
she
to be on Friendster.
Age. I don't know. She might be 26. Stomped Ariel Pink. What's Friendster? Friendster was basically it was the thing before MySpace, is what I think. What about Bebo? Boost. My yearbook. Oh! God. Neither did I. I didn't have Facebook until 2009 in the fall. How's that for you? Now I'm boosting on there. Unstoppable.
What was that one, like... What was that other thing for downloading music besides LimeWire? There's something.
Napster?
No, there's another one.
Oh,
if I could remember it, I would have floods of memories come back, but I can't think of it right now.
Did it start with a Q?
Maybe.
If you having girl problems, I feel bad for you, son. I got 99 problems, but if you ain't one, hit me. 99 problems, but if you ain't one. If you having girl problems, I feel bad for you, son. I got 99 problems, but if you ain't one, hit me.
Rated M for mature.
I used it too. I downloaded Slipknot, Wait and Bleed on Napster.
I used to associate Slipknot with white trash.
Well, I associated it with my whole life, so... I have pics of Yngwie Malmsteen. Wow, that's awesome.
Sorry, bro. That has no reflection on you.
Oh,
just being honest about my past.
It's totally fine. Well, it's everybody's past. It's
our collective past. I had lots of funny records I used to own. I had a Sugar Ray album. I had a who were the guys who said that one? I had Everclear. I had at 311.
I have a Stain CD I could put on right now.
I had Bush.
It's not actually mine.
I had
Linkin Park.
Oh, I had, who are those guys, and walked upon high, Collective Soul.
Collective
I had Collective Soul.
Soul.
I had, what other terrible music? I never had Uncle Cracker. I remember hearing them on the radio. Who else?
Does anybody know Pancho's question? He asked, can we discuss whether Lincoln...
Fastball. Fuel, yeah, Fuel. Peter Beattie. I had Fuel. That song with, like, the little, like, Indian tablas in the background. They're, like, little ballad. Peter Beattie just always seems on point. Peter, I feel like you're my musical soulmate to some degree.
Yeah, he always seems to know things
that I know.
You guys...
We always seem to have similar references. Either that or I don't know. Maybe it's just a coincidence.
Will Smith. I had Big Willie Style on cassette.
I had terrible bands. What other terrible bands did I have? Filter.
Damn,
okay. Well,
Yellow Card is fucking...
I remember Yellow Card, but I didn't have their CD. I remember, like, my friend had their CD.
They were singing Yellow Card at that party a couple weeks ago, and I felt...
Yellow Card, their songs
were
great.
I felt like it was really good.
I like Yellow Card. I like those two songs. They're good.
Alexi, that's funny. Seems good. Seems funny.
Grandma. There was a girl at work for a while whose name was Haley Williams. And then when she left, I couldn't find her on Facebook because her name is Haley Williams.
Damn.
That's tragic, isn't it?
Yeah, people shouldn't be allowed to have common names, like, once there's a certain
number. Yeah, well, that's also the name of the front woman for Paramore.
I know. Damn. Talk about...
You guys remember Korn Bullet with a whatever video? That was a cool video.
Talk about memeplex. Insane Clown Posse has a gigantic memeplex.
Remember when Limp Bizkit ruined that Who song? Yeah, Freak on a Leaf.
Limp Bizkit?
I had Rage Against the Machine. I had System of a Down. Do you guys have System of a Down?
I've got Behind Blue Eyes dubstep remix on my, on a playlist.
What other issues do they have?
Did you listen to Static X?
No, but I know that band.
Well, I mean...
They had a song called Wisconsin Death Trip.
Yeah.
That was the name of their album.
Did that get you off because you were from Wisconsin?
No.
I was wondering if it might.
Their video is sweet, though. I posted it on your wall one time, I think. Or I tried to.
Static X?
Yeah. Mm-hmm. So it's hard to get to find their music video. They're awesome. What other bands?
Apple Palm. Osha. Nice. That's an interesting format, Dave.
I feel like people are getting into your eccentric way of constructing sentences. The hell is me?
Oh, yeah, that's...
I mean, like, the vibe of the sentences reminds me of...
Yeah, it doesn't really mean...
And also, there's lots of crying in your poems, also.
Maybe.
In the emo ones. In, like, the poster ones, yeah. Like, cuddling. Lots of, like, sensitive emotions. It's not negative.
Oh, no, I'm good.
It's descriptive.
Oh, no, I'm good.
Not negative.
Sam! Welcome to my heart.
But I'm just saying, I think you're having an influence as
well.
So.
Well, good. I like that. I mean, I just get it from other people. Start with. A lot of that was from Cummings, you know?
Yeah.
With the version. Oh, God. Is that an updated thing?
Is that the same one? I think it's just the same thing.
It is the same. It's a different screenshot.
Yeah. I'm a big fan of that. That made me laugh a lot when I saw it.
Oh, okay, what should we do now? It's been an hour and a half.
Really?
Yeah.
Do you mind if we make popcorn? I feel bad. I shouldn't ask for popcorn.
No, I can make popcorn.
Hungry.
Oh, you're not hungry?
No, I am, but you're not. And it's your popcorn. Make a food.
Make a food. Well, I feel a little hungry. I mean, I can make popcorn.
If you don't mind.
But
I should make you something sometime to make up for it.
You should go get some. You should order some. I have no idea.
I can order something, but
don't order anything. It's always popcorn. Who's substitute teacher? I remember you. Are you Shannon?
I love popcorn.
We're not on the same level. Whoops, there we are.
Level!
I like that.
Noise.
I don't know if you guys can tell, but the computer's on an angle.
No, I've got a request from Eric Kelly. You don't have to tell me twice.
Wow. A lot of you are probably like getting out of college. If you are in college, probably getting out for winter break, it probably feels awesome as heck. I'm like really excited to be home because I just associate it with that feeling. Getting done with the semester. Pancho Espinosa. Okay, a lot of people still have a week left. It's respectable. I'll go make the popcorn.
Sure. Some people
pop
sit
cross.
Right there and can't say what's on their minds. Some people wanna freak. Some are just too damn shy. With me, that's not the deal. Girl, I say how I feel. Wanna see something I like. I'm gonna keep it real. For instance, you look like food. I won't put you on my plate.
Would you like
some
that?
You up some biscuits and go on and eat you, babe.
Would you like that, girl?
Do you make it rain? Grab my ears and pull my face. Tonight I'll be giving you praise.
Generally, I don't get your comment. You said, sometimes I think about Space Jam when I give word ups. Are you guys monsters? Are you flirting?
This song goes out
people out there that be running their mouth, and they don't know what the hell they saying. Shut up. Now that I've got my voice back, let me start off by saying that
this fucking chills.
Fuck! Fans around the world that had my back. I just wanna thank God I'm standing
God damn.
With his hands on me, keeping all the doctors focused through my surgery. Now, there's a couple of things I gotta get off my chest. Serious issues that I must address. Well, let's just get right to it.
God damn, you're standing up, bro. Watch out for the
said there was no way this time he's gonna overcome. And even before the doctors was done,
this song feels like pumped as fuck.
Maybe it's not. It
seems pumped,
though. After 22 years of a blessed career, had me lying in my hospital bed,
my chair while standing.
Just as I had many people
skateboarding on that chair, bro.
Let's not forget the hood around the world loving me. To everybody that be calling me, telling me what they be saying.
This should be dubstep remix, though. You're right. Grace, hi, how are you? Grace wants us to kiss.
No.
Dom wants us to kiss.
Shut up. Tell him. Shut up.
God dang, I'm sorry.
Shut up.
We've hugged.
Shut up and tell them I'm talking to you. I'm going to go away, but when it's time for me to go, my God is going to
hold me. He's like,
just try to get by, but sometimes it's so hard.
Yeah, I like the like weird angle thing.
Large for the lad is Joe Roberts.
The news said I lost my house. My own people put me down. And my friends no longer around. No. But you see deep underneath the
sun. God dang. Stained? Y'all wanna put on some stain? Look, God.
My future ain't my past. It's not the end of the hourglass. Said it would not last. Man, sick.
Shut up.
What should we do right now?
We should go look at the popcorn, although it's still charging. Probably should let it charge. How do we keep the energy high? Oh, dude, is your cord, like, fucked or something?
It's a little fucked.
I just didn't want to make it more fucked.
That'll be okay. Yay!
I feel like it's... I mean, I don't want to... I mean, I want to be careful with your computer, but it's exciting to move it around.
We can... I mean, it's got most of the way charged.
Okay, guys, we're going to check on the factory. There's some easy... Oh, God. Holy fuck, can you smell that? Oh, wait.
They can't smell it.
I'm kidding.
Yay! Oh my God! An actual tree can smell it.
Hey, can I see? Is it on screen right now?
Yep, it's perfectly on screen. It's popping!
It's popping!
You guys hear the popcorn cracking? This thing can hold 6 quarts of popcorn. Put in about 3/4 cup. It seems a little odd. It's not popping up as much. I think I didn't put as much oil. Maybe there's affects it a little.
Oh God, I'm so horny for this popcorn, guys. Are you horny for this popcorn?
Oh my God!
Holy fuck!
It was still popping, guys. Still popping. Ah! It's still popping. Ah! Jackson's peen is overwhelming the scent in the whole chat room.
Let's plug it in again just so I can be like real mobile. Later.
Chat roulette.
Just so it'll have a long-lasting charge. I think I have to be at like a goddamn meeting at like 8 tomorrow.
Shut up.
It's a catchy song.
Shut up.
I'm talking to you. Shut up. Give me your books on me.
Goddamn.
Whoa.
wish I knew what to read.
I like to exploit this zany angle.
I really don't know how zany it looks to other people. It doesn't seem like a bad
zany. Oh, it's not zany to them, is it?
Oh, it's probably a little
zany. How do we make it zany if we're straight?
Y'all like Theodore Rupke at all?
Who is that?
He's a poet.
I should find my all this thing.
He wrote some chill-ass poetry near the beginning of his life. Maybe in the middle of his life? Let me find the ones I like the most. And then... The Far Field I liked a lot. And then he started writing some, like, children's type poetry. Jesus Christ. This shit will get you fucked up. I'm going to read Section 5 from Theodore Rupke, The Long Waters. Okay? Theodore Rupke. Rothke. Okay. As light reflects from a lake in late evening, when bats fly close to slightly tilting brownish water, and the low ripples run over a pebbly shoreline, as a fire, seemingly long dead, flares up from a downdraft of air in a chimney, or a breeze moves over the knees from a low hill, so the sea wind wakes desire. My body shimmers with a light flame. I see in the advancing and retreating waters the shape that came from my sleep, weeping. The eternal one, the child, the swaying vine branch, the numinous ring around the opening flower, the friend that runs before me on the windy headlands, neither voice nor vision. I, who came back from the depths laughing too loudly, become another thing. My eyes extend beyond the farthest bloom of the waves. I lose and find myself in the long water. I am gathered together once more. I embrace the world. How you like that shit? Especially the last line. I embrace the world. Theodore Rutke. Rutke. This book is for sale in my fundraiser. Get that shit. Read it up. And live a happier life as a result. My God! This is for sale in the fundraiser. Do you know this shit? Lynn Hajinian, language poet. Pretty sure no one got this yet. I'm not currently fully updated on the newest people. The orders. I'm a little behind. This is pretty good. Not gonna read it right now, though. Oh my God, my life! Yeah, she's... They're on discount selling because they spelled life wrong on the cover. Pottery 101. We covered my life in my MFA class, too, and I didn't read it for the class, but I had read it previously, and so I just said stuff about it that I already had thought about it, and I didn't think for the class. Okay. Oh, God. Did the people in the class get me? Yes, because I speak fluidly in the language of postmodernism. Now, I went to a reading, it was a presentation by Tao Lin a couple days ago. And it was about his drawings and his Photoshop art and his art in general. And it was funny because I feel like this is some boosted stuff. He was talking about
all the different ideas he puts together for his drawings. And he's got all these templates, like the hamster, fish, you know, and some other ones that he hasn't done as much online, like panda, star, but stuff he's done here and there. And other ones that he's never really done, like car. But here it is. He also put together this thing where it suggests that you can combine the different aspects to come up with all these. And this is boosted, I feel. This one right here, it says it is seeing impaired winged star turtle hybrid with happy / deceased facial expression skateboarding. That's awesome. And this one down here is a good combo too. I feel like he should pump out these sort of combinations on his actual Tumblr and stuff. Obese organic certified guinea pig okapi hybrid crying tears of joy while half deceased. It's pretty advanced. So I could include these with somebody's order too. Just even more reason to help me live my life. I could include this unopened credit card offer from Capital One to me. Did you enjoy the hand turkey? I love the hand turkey, Alexi. I was so heartwarmed that you made that. I think it's crazy when people make things based on things I've made or something, or make things for me. That's awesome. Sierra on a... No. Spanish. Hey, do you guys want to... This is a camera. Anybody can buy this too. This is a camera of mine though. You know what would be interesting? I don't know if anybody's interested in this, but it'd be funny to sell this with the film that's already in it that has probably like 20 pictures of stuff. Anyway, I'm gonna take a picture of the chat room right now, so type things that you want to be in this picture, and then you're going to be in the, your chat is going to be in the picture. This is a fisheye lens camera. It's like a gimmick camera. It's a Lomography brand camera. So I'll just give you a few seconds to type some group photo in the chat. I know it's very exciting. I am in the picture. Oh my god, what do I want it to be remembered by? Alexi, you want it? Do you want it with or without the film inside of it? I'm sure there's nothing too revealing in it or anything. Kick my long ass. I like that a lot. Okay, here we go. I'm zooming. I'm going way up close. Okay, I took it, but I guess what? I'm going to take another one with a different camera. This is a disposable crap camera that I still haven't finished from a long time ago. 2010 maybe. Okay, so here we go. I'm gonna wait for a little bit more comments to... Okay. Okay. Power. Thanks. Steven? Are you reading? Oh, thought you were reading the newspaper. If you put Vaseline on the lens, it looks like Lomography. That's funny. Ah! Oh, wow. Boost. You guys ever eat sunflower seeds? Damn. Check this out. I eat them without even taking the shells off. I just chew the shells right in. Boost.
Wait, are you getting some popcorn action?
Oh, no. I didn't get it yet. No, I just pulled this out from my drawer. I had these in my drawer. How's that? Fennel tea. I just chew the shells right up. It's very G of you. How do you figure? And what does that mean, that it's G of me? Yeah. Michael, I do that with the peanut butters, chocolate chips. Fuck yeah. You know what? You know what's even better though, Michael? In my opinion, you get peanuts, and chocolate chips in the same handful. Roasted, probably dry roasted peanuts, chocolate chips. Tastes like chocolate covered peanuts once you get it chewed up a little, if you got the right combination. What? Now, here's a trick that I did in the past. This is absurd. You can't eat this. You can't eat this, but I tried. I used to do this thing where I'd put a lot of peanut butter in a bowl, like a cereal bowl, and then I'd pour a lot of chocolate chips in it and just mix it up. So it was a big bowl of peanut butter and chocolate chips and just...
If you having girl problems, I feel bad for you, son. I got 99 problems, but if you ain't one, hit me. 99 problems, but if you ain't one. If you having girl problems, I feel bad for you, son. I got 99 problems, but if you ain't one, hit me.
Rated M for mature.
I don't care if I eat it.
Jesus. I don't even care about eating a popcorn.
Well,
where's your salt at? Oh, there it is.
This is my seasoning that I use for popcorn. It says buttery salt, but it's not butter. It's artificial stuff.
I'm trying to find like a funny email to read. Like times of yore. But like a recent one.
Oh, yeah.
I don't know if I've sent you.
From me and you? Yeah, not super fun. Or at least it hasn't been a focus.
Still doesn't seem like enough salt. Did you say you have a... What was the deal with your other salt?
There's a bigger sea salt shaker. It's just... It also comes slow out of that.
Oh.
Like, I think it's down below. I can find it. No, the other... Mm-hmm. Yeah, that big shaker.
Let's try it.
It can get clogged in that, too. Damn, I'm thirsty. Hey, guys. Gatorade on the stove with cinnamon. Check this out. When I was in high school or something, I would experiment with different Kool-Aid combinations, experimental Kool-Aid, and one time I tried put cinnamon on there, and it just didn't mix in. There was just little blobs of cinnamon, powdered cinnamon, just floating on the top of the Kool-Aid. Live my life. Rare. I know. This is good, though. You guys do anything boosted with Kool-Aid ever? Mixing different Kool-Aid? Like, I would put, like, three packets, three times as much sugar, you know, mix it in. This is popcorn that I popped on the popper. And it's organic yellow popcorn. It's pretty simple popcorn. And then with olive, it's popped in olive oil, and I'm using this seasoning on it, Zass Rose popcorn seasoning. So it's a little, it's pretty damn tasty, if I do say so myself. I don't own a microwave currently. Brian Lowney, losing his effing mind, I'm loosing my mind. I want to try a popcorn seasoning with nutritional yeast, but I haven't really found it out. I haven't done it.
Makes more sense.
Yeah. Ty Lynn is a great guy.
Yep.
We had both met him about a year ago, too, when he was in Chicago a different time. He's a great guy. He's quiet, but he's very funny and nice. He's cool.
Great.
What did you say great to?
Best Kool-Aid flavor.
Yeah. Oh, best Kool-Aid flavor. There's one that's like ice blue or something, isn't it? Like, it's pretty goddamn cool, if I say so myself. I'm going all over the place on tour or whatever it is. But I don't know exactly the order and stuff. And it depends at how much money I have and if I get sick of it. If I'll actually get to go everywhere or if I'll just bail on it at some point. I think I'm going to go to the East Coast first. New York City and probably Atlanta and North Carolina. And maybe Montreal. Samuel, what part of Canada do you live in?
International. Does Cameron live in ATL?
Yeah, I think so.
Who's off on duty?
Cameron Guthrie. Yeah, I'm going to stay with Michael Heslemile, pretty sure. And I'm going to have a reading with Blake Butler, too. I think. By T.O., do you mean Toronto?
Sweet. Hi, Ollie.
Ernie Butler. Oh, Iowa City, yeah. Well, see, I was kind of thinking of it in terms of the three different strips down the country, like East Coast mostly, Midwest, middle of the country, and then West Coast, and then also possibly London. So, Iowa City would fit into the middle strip probably, but I don't know for sure when I'll be doing that bit. It's delicious, Peter. Peter, do you live in a wood cabin? Peter Beattie? I feel like we talked in email and he was alluding to a wood cabin or... Yes. Don't you see him living in a wood cabin?
I don't know. Isn't he like the alias of someone else?
Would Peter Beattie really be the alias of somebody else? I don't know.
No, he's probably just himself. I don't know.
The Universal Tour video? What do you mean, Dom? Tap. Who's Tap Out Hoodie? That's a funny username.
It's all dark again.
Are there
hipster on hippie hate crimes in Asheville?
In Asheville?
I think that would be a funny question to ask. Because they just said it was filled with dirty hippies.
Filthy hippies? Oh, Stewie Hoodie. Boost. I just followed you on Twitter. Pretty sure. Hey, baby. Boosh. Asheville, I don't know. The person I know that I'll probably stay with in North Carolina is in Chapel Hill. But maybe I'll go on a road trip.
You should probably lift her energy somehow. Can't tell if I've had just like a weird combination of foods today.
Yeah.
I don't know, the last couple of days.
You think this was a good choice though, popcorn?
You know, it's something to do.
Santa baby. I haven't played drums much in the past few years, but I could.
A baby, a trap tap, C-O-K-2, light blue. I'll wait up for you to send a baby, and every time I tell you to
$50. What would you get?
Think of all the fun.
Well, right now I would get a comforter, a seat.
$50 gift certificate to Target. I don't even know. I'd buy a replacement shade for the window since I broke the one that's here, and it might help me get a subletter. Or make them more satisfied upon moving in. I don't really need anything else. Maybe I'd buy gifts for my family.
A cutie, and hurry down the chimney tonight. Oh, yeah, Santa baby, fill my stocking with the Rolex and checks. Sign your ex on the line, Santa baby, and hurry down the chimney tonight. Come and trade my Christmas tree with some decorations for this honey's.
Wow.
I really do.
Maybe
you. Let's see if you believe in me. Santa baby, forget to mention one else thing. The ring. I don't mean on the phone. Santa baby, and hurry down the chimney.
I am drinking.
Hurry down the chimney tonight.
Sparkling clementine. It's my favorite beverage that exists. I think that's true because it's also healthy. I mean, it's as healthy as juice.
Doesn't it have like calories and stuff?
Yeah, but I mean, it's like drinking fucking orange juice without the fiber of the pulp. I mean, it's like, it's pretty healthy. It has calories, but not any more than juice. They're kind of like healthy calories, in a way. I mean, What else should we do? Do you have any ideas?
I don't know.
Maybe it's hard to do things while we're eating, I don't know.
No, I might stop eating this.
Johnny wants to take a look inside the fridge.
There's almost really nothing in there.
There's not much in the fridge, but I'll show you. Freezer. Coffee. Frozen fruit. More frozen fruit. Veggie burgers. Frozen peas. Water. Spaghetti sauce, milk, carrots, baby carrots, carrot importantly, seitan, apple juice, and some condiments, and vegan butter. Rare-based footage. Show us the condiment bar. This is all the condiments. There's not that much. There's like, I don't even use many of these condiments. A lot of them were left over from my ex-girlfriend being here. There's barbecue sauce, soy sauce, jelly, mayonnaise, which is like vegan mayonnaise, strawberry jam, ketchup mustard. Behind the scenes. Simply having a wonderful Christmas time, that's funny. That seems really fun to do. You still can go get it if you want, but... Yeah.
Still feeling kind of depressed.
Want a hug?
Sure.
Yeah. Dubstep monster? I don't know what that would mean.
Someone said Monstar earlier. I don't know if it's the same person.
That was Johnny Volpine that said this. Draw a picture of a dubstep monster. Johnny, I would like to write you a poem about a dubstep monster. Oh my god. WTFFTL. Baby carrots forever. Zombie Skrillex. Michael, did you upload?
Like you got one of those cool like thin ties there. Those are good. Is that a tie?
I think that's a belt.
Oh.
Yeah, but I... Yeah, I don't have really cool thin ties. I have kind of thin ties, like this one.
This is just a style of, like, 70s tie that kind of looks like that.
Yeah. There are...
I had an English teacher
cool
used to wear it.
Freaking skinny ties.
No. Steve...
Pancho Espinosa says goodbye to everybody in the chat because he got kicked out and he couldn't get back in or something.
Oh my god.
He's got to do homework anyway.
Bye, Pancho.
Pancho Espinosa.
No, it's not Pancho, guys. It's Pancho.
The spelling is Pancho, but it's pronounced Pancho because it's Spanish language. What should we effing do? Is there anything else to even do? I feel kind of how I did the last time we did a Ustream in that, I felt
like, maybe self-indulgent or, like, why would these people be watching me right now? I'm not doing anything, or we're not doing anything. People say that they have interest anyway, so I don't know. Kitty Cat is back there. Switch shirts. The kitty's name is Gabby. Her full name is Mrs. Frances Picabia or Gabrielle Buffet Picabia. This is base footage. Yeah, she's named after the Dada painter-poet Frances Picabia's wife. This is a dubstep remix of Pumped Up Kicks that somebody linked. Dom linked it. Wait for the drop. Alright. Yeah. I don't think it's not quite as monstrous. Did you ever see this video? This guy dancing? It's kind of lame. It looks like a video kind of. Yeah. I've seen other people do that kind of dance, but I feel like tight ass dancing. I have not heard the Nickelback.
I really don't like Nickelback.
I don't think I've heard any Nickelback dubstep. I liked Pump the Fix for quite a while.
I don't understand. I mean, it's totally fine, I just don't like
it. I liked it for quite a while, even after it was popular, but I don't really anymore. I think I listened to it too much. I'm gonna do the look at this photograph dubstep. It better be the top YouTube result.
Nickel dub.
Seems funny.
Already.
I'll link that friend's video. God damn, this is good. This new level indeed. This is a really funny idea. Oh,
This is good. Damn.
Well, that was good. That was a lot more fun than I expected.
Yeah, that was pretty awesome. Alright. I loved it. I think it was great.
Which one is Tap Out Hoodie again? Hi, Tap Out Hoodie.
He said his name. He's my new Twitter friend. Starts with a Stewie hoodie.
Oh, and he knows that other person.
Yeah, knows Tully.
They're shitting.
Can we take a break for now? You can. Anybody can take a break at any point, I guess.
Maybe we could just stop.
We could stop. It's been over 2 hours. Posting it on FB. Frick yeah. Share that shit. That's Dom Carnicelli. The haha, oh really. Bass Robot Remix. Frick yeah, that's a great song.
Bass Freestyle.
Mmm.
Oh yeah, that sounds great.
Yeah.
Gracie and the motherfucking thing. I'm a robot. Get butt naked. Will B's the best. Will B's my favorite.
I thought how I really said that their name was Liz.
I've heard we run Scraper. Check it out.
Everybody go crazy. Me and this motherfucker going 1880. All my niggas like
so good.
Pop fun and pop rocks. Yes, sir. I'm dope like chop chops and rock rocks. Yeah. Everybody know that we on the vibe. Yes,
what do you have for me, Cuddy? Cuddy buddy? My little putty buddy? I demand my respect.
Yes, I freestyle based on all the bass freestyle. Yes, all the
yeah. Yeah.
Can't stop it, we in this motherfucker to the top. All day. All day, and we can't even motherfucking stop.
I don't need, so I don't want to do anything. Can't get rid of my stuff.
Everybody go crazy, and I know that I got hella bitches like me.
I'm gonna play the hot and red.
Oh, it's hot and red.
Now,
they're here.
The holiday season begins with a bang. Get the movie that's pure entertainment.
That was too funny. Which one's Brian? I don't think I know Wyatt.
Hey Jeff, you still those shoes? No, you already got those Adidas's in. Yeah, that's pretty awesome. You get from the shuttle bob? Those come through like fucking Jack Downs or something? Fuck you, man.
Why is the fucking thing so slow?
It's all red.
This is a longer video than I thought.
this is interesting to me.
What the fuck is going on?
Oh my god. Do you want it to be done with, or do you not care, or do you have any idea for the end of it?
No.
Just being lost a lot of years. Oh yeah, generally. It's still plenty of people, but but I don't know, I mean, most of them had already seen it for a while.
It would make sense for having that, yeah.
Hey, buddies! Thank you all for coming so much and hanging out, and I hope it's, hope it was fun, not boring, and, if it was boring, then just don't come next time.
Go.
Face God, miss, go. Go. I'll be doing lots of Ustreams when I'm traveling. So I'll probably do Ustreams with various people who I'm staying with.
The Wub Machine. Does that make everything wub-wubby?
Damn, makes me want to try it, but not right now.
Oh, I wouldn't let him say it.
Oh!
No problem, Michael.
Oh, I made a dubstep remix of my video. Damn, that's cool.
Hmm.
Well, thank you guys for coming so much.
Thanks, guys and gals.
I'm glad you think it was a fun time. That's awesome as heck. Johnny, you mean your apartment in Texas? In the south of Texas? In the freaking bottom point of Texas? I don't know if it will work out with my route, but I'm tempted because it would be warm.
Who's Izzy W?
Izzy Waxman? I think she lives in New York City.
Oh, cool.
Yeah.
Hi, Izzy.
Izzy. Witch house. Live my witch house. Life. There is a girl at the thing where we went to the person's house with Tao.
She was laughing.
This was a funny story, though.
Oh, okay.
Not that funny, but just funny enough to keep it on. There was this girl, though, who I hadn't said hi to the whole night. But when she was leaving, she's like, "I'm Rachel, bye." Like, she, like, introduced herself right before leaving.
Well, that's
kind of
nice.
Because it was like, I sort of nodded or waved or something, and she, like, she was, like, gonna say bye, but then, like, she hadn't said hello yet. So
yeah,
she, like, said hello and then said bye.
Whereas, like, some of the people seemed like they wanted us to get out of there.
Yeah. Extremely. Boost. Okay. I love you, friends.
Bye, guys.
I keep in great contact with all of you, I know that, because most of you got this link from other places I posted on the internet, or Steven, and we're pretty all tied together, so.
All tied up.
All tied up.
Might have large feet. Is that the name for real? That's nice.
That's good, Joe Roberts. Okay, I love you, buddies.
Bye.
Bye, 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 bye.